Too open. Too open.
Center. There's a shot of Dana Altman, the Creighton Blue Jays' 11th year head coach. He won his 200th game earlier this season. Time now to take over the starting lineup for the Creighton Blue Jays. They're brought to you by Coventry Health of Nebraska. Creighton goes with a three-guard attack. Nate Funk, Kellen Milliner. There's Tyler McKinney, the young man we talked about in the open. Jimmy Motes, who is a young man from Lincoln, and Anthony Tolliver. 10 to shoot. First possession of the game for the Jays. Funk in the dribble drive. Pull up.
Pass today, and that's not just on the defensive end. It's on the offensive end on those long misses. They need to come up with some offensive boards.
Tolliver with a jump hook, gets his own back and puts it in. 4-0.
Jason DeRusso. McKinney with it out high. Nebraska very active on the defensive end right now.
Yeah, they are being very active with their hands, overplaying some passing lanes, trying to put a lot of pressure on the guards for the Creighton Blue Jays.
Five on the shot clock. McKinney out high. That's Milner. Steps inside. Flips. Got it. Three different Jays have scored.
Very well. They're well scouted. And it's going to be tough. Points are going to be tough to come by today. It's going to be 60, 65 points. It'll be about all either team's going to get today.
Funk for three. Rattles out. Watts to follow.
That's what Nebraska can. Creighton was in a zone there. And you know, Coach Altman has told his team, find Marcus Neal, find Joe McCray. Those are the guys that are going to shoot.
Milner for three. He answers at the other end for Creighton.
Let's see, Ben. Right now, Creighton only shooting 26%.
Eight to shoot. That's Watts for three.
That's what they do so well. Nebraska, how good we were from behind the arc in 2003 and 4, losing Nate Johnson and Brian Conklin. Brings that percentage down a little.
Milner with a spins, flips, missed it. Rebound, battle for it. Howard goes up, McCray gets it, and we hit halftime. Good spirit. First half of action. Nebraska trailed throughout, but grabbed the lead with about 4 minutes to go and will take a four-point lead into the locker room. 22-18, Nebraska with the advantage on Creighton. Nebraska Classic in Lincoln today. Our halftime coming up next on FSN.
A couple opportunities squandered there for Nebraska. Got into the lane with a couple decent looks at the basket. Not able to extend the lead in the first possession of the half.
Four is the biggest lead of the game for Nebraska. Funk with a pull up. Crawls in. Now he was quiet for most of that first half. Still battling down low. Day has it. Jump hook, got it. His first two of the game.
Good move that.
Rebound by Watts. Milliner for three. He rips it. Creighton back in front by one.
Tyler McKinney found him on the break that time.
Milliner goes right wing. Eight to shoot. Milliner needs help. Finds Mathis. Back to Milliner. Top of the key three.
Of all guys to be left open. Sometimes when there's a
Creighton with a weave out high. Funk for three. Yes. His first three of the game, and Creighton up by two with 7:35 to go. McKinney weaving through traffic in the corner to Milner.
Can't believe it.
That's his fourth three of the game. He has 18 in the contest for the year. Now, today, they've not been as accurate behind the line, but Funk, obviously, a threat late in the game, as is Milner.
Plenty of guys who can knock it down from behind the arc, but Creighton right now isn't necessarily thinking three-pointer. They just want to, after this timeout, get into their offense and try to get a good look. A two is just fine at this point in the game.
McKinney on high to Funk. 3-point Big Red lead. Funk inside. Nice move up and in for two.
Great up and under.
Huskers playing sound defense. Now Funk, free throw line, off to Miller. 17-footer, no good. Watch gets bumped from behind by Will. See him red, waving the arms. And he drills it. Six in the game for Watts. Tied at 45, a minute 21 to go.
For Nebraska right here, you need to box out on a miss.
Watts gets them both.
Along with Marcus Neal. And a couple different guys you might see take the shot are Marcus Neal. Wes Wilkinson's been good until there where he turned it over.
Turek was trying to get a seal, and then just the defender kind of backed away, and John tripped backwards. And a turnover. No need to foul here, though.
No, play solid defense. One-point game, even if they get a bucket. Still a one-possession game unless they hit a three.
You can see on your screen both the game clock and the shot clock. 45 seconds left of the game. 10 on the shot clock. McKinney flips. Got it. Tyler McKinney's first field goal of the game gives Creighton a 3-point lead.
Wow, 39 seconds to go.
Three here, just need a bucket. You get a good look at a three, DeRusso for three. He makes it in there. He banks in his second 3-point field goal of the year. We are tied at 48.
I don't know what kind of angle he had there or if he meant to call Kiss, but he banked it in from the side of the court there to tie it up.
Creighton can go for the last shot. Shot clock off. 10 seconds left in the game. Funk has it. Muehlheisen on him. Funk, dribble drive, shot, blocked out of bounds by Wilkinson. Creighton will keep it 3-point, 2 seconds left in the game.
Good job, help defense by Wes Wilkinson. See who they look for here, Funk or yeah. Milliner?
Milliner, pull-up jumper, he got it off, and he drills it at the horn, and Creighton has won it. Well, there's 0.4 seconds left in the game. Milliner hits a 15-foot floater on the wing, and the Jays have a 2-point lead on Nebraska.
Off the inbounds, they had four guys across the baseline. Milliner was the guy that caught the inbounds pass. Put the ball on the deck, pulled up. Nice mid-range jump shot, nothing but net.
That he can get. Milliner with a nice little shake move to get some space. And then drills it. 0.8, you could put about 0.4 seconds back on the clock. You go by that.
Has to be a long pass down the court.
Turek fires. Neal catches, shoots, and a count of it goes, and just off the front iron. And Creighton has upset Nebraska here this afternoon. 50-48.